So what we are going to see, the next topic is, we are going to see method overriding and dynamic dispatch method. Okay. So for that, we are going to take our old program. Maybe we can take, main.java. Okay. So assume there is a class called animal and there is a class called dog, and we have the main demo like that, and this animal will have a get name, and this dog will have the method get breed. What happens is, like, if we give a different name, it won't be any problem. Okay, so what happens if we give a same name? For example, so string, so get name is the method that is associated with animal, so string name. And another one, we have the same method name in the dog also. Okay, and what happens when we create object, like assuming the animal has the get name and the dog also have the same method name get name. Okay, what happens if you create an object for dog? So dog d equal to new dog. And what happens, like, when you call d dot get name, assuming that I am going to pass the value as here, like dog. And d dot get name, assuming that I'm going to pass the breed name here, like puppy, like that. So what is the output you'll get when I compile? So java c space main demo dot java, so java space main demo. Think I put some I think there is a mistake. Wait. Get name, okay, get name. Okay, so it is printing this one. Okay. Okay, I can. So now what you can see is, like, first you are getting the dog value as this D, and the name of the animal, like, you are not able to get this one because the name of, normally what you are trying to get is D dot get name as dog. What normally you are expected the output is name of the animal is plus dog, like that. But what you are getting is the breed name of dog. That means you are getting like a derived class method. So when I pass this d dot get name, you'll get breed name of dog as plus dog. And again pass d dot get name of puppy, you will get the breed name of dog as puppy, like that. You are not able to get the base class methods. Okay, so this property or this concept is called as method overriding. When we have the same name in the base class and the same name in the derived class, what happens is, when you create the object for the derived class, the derived class property will override the properties of base class, and this concept is called as method overriding. Okay, so this method of overriding can be prevented with the help of dynamic dispatch method. Okay, can you all understand the concept of method overriding? Again, I will repeat it. So assume we have two different classes, and assuming it uses the same method with the same number of arguments, what happens when you create an object for the derived classes? The direct class method will override the base class method, and you will get the result only from the direct class method. So this concept is called as method overriding. Okay. So to overcome this, what we can do is we should not take this extends animal. So we should use this inheritance, and also we should make sure that you will get this name of the animal and also the breed name of the dog like that. So to do that, we have to follow something called dynamic dispatch method. So dynamic dispatch method. So what you will do in step one is, in step one, what you have to do is, so let me delete this one out. In step one, create a reference for base class. So the base class reference is animal. So I will give animal A like that. Okay. Now I will create the first thing like this one. So now I will call the method like animal A then. So if I want to print this base class, that is get name, I will first create another object animal A equal to new animal. Then I will pass this AA to A. So A equal to AA. Then I will print this A, that is A dot get name. Let me compile it. Sorry. Method get name in class animal cannot be applied to given types. Okay. So we have to pass the value dog. So now you are getting the name of the animal is dog like that. Now how will you get the name of the so this is step two. Create an object for class one and assign to base reference. Now what we have to do is create the object for, this is step three, create the object for class two, that is dog, and assign to base reference. So this is step three. So what I will do is I will create a object for dog. So dog D equal to new dog. I will assign to the base reference. So this is base reference A. So A animal A equal to D. Then A dot get name of followed by puppy. So first compile, then execute. Now you can get the values that is inside the animal, that is the name of the animal is dog and the breed name of the dog is puppy like that. So this is how we can print both base class and direct class methods using dynamic dispatch method. So first thing is we have to create the so this is the base class. We have to create the reference for the base class assuming animal A. So now A is the reference. Now we have to create the object for this animal. So object of the animal is created. So I have assigned that referenced object with this current value of the object like A equal to AA. Then A dot get name of dog. So now it will print this one. And I will create the object for the dog again. And what I will do is I will assign that to a base reference A. And after that, using that base reference, I can get the name of the breed. So using this, I can able to print this one as well as this one. So this concept of a base class referencing is called as dynamic dispatch method. Okay. So anyone have any doubt in this dynamic dispatch method? So this is a very important topic where like, so in interview they will ask what is DMD like that. So DMD is like a dynamic dispatch method. It's like a method for preventing method overriding. So the step has to be followed is first we have to create a base class reference. Then what are all the class we want to use? Then we have to assign that to a we have to create object for that particular class. Then we have to assign that to a base class reference. Then using that base class reference, we can print that. For example, the base class reference is A here. Then I will use two classes. So I will create object for that two classes. So the object for the first class is AA. So I will assign that to a reference. Then using that reference, I am printing that the first class method. Similarly, using the second class, I will print the second class method like that. So this is all about dynamic dispatch method. Yeah, the question is like how the memory allocated for this kind of steps. So the memory is like it is allocated with the help of heap. What it will do is first it will like when it will create a reference or a memory for the base class reference called A. So it will create a reference maybe like this. I will explain. So first if you use A like animal A, okay, so now assume this is a heap and this is our object. Okay, so this will be first it will be the memory allocated. It will be like this. Then if I create like animal object, another thing like AA equal to new animal like that. Now again AA will be created. Now if I use like A equal to AA, that means this object is get referenced to this one. Similarly, when I use another thing like dog D equal to new dog. So it will create another reference called, so this will be assigned, D will be assigned. Then if you use like A equal to D, this will be get assigned here. So we are just using this as the reference. So we are just using this as the reference. Okay. So we are using this as the reference. We are using this as the reference. Using that reference, we are assigning this object and we are printing the values in which we want to. Okay. So this level is called as like a dynamic dispatch method. To avoid multiple overriding. So overriding is the concept in which if we have a same method name in base class and derived class, only the derived class method will be get displayed, because the derived class method will override the base class method. To prevent that method overriding, we'll go for this dynamic dispatch method. Any doubt? So how will the question is like how the memories and the references are created. It is the objects will be created in the heap and the references are created inside the heap. So there will be some different topics like when you create something, it will put that everything in a stack. When you, for example, when you create a variable or when you create an object, everything it will be put in the stack. And what it will happen is when you create an object, and when we call that object, the memory will be allocated in the heap and it will get called. Okay, so that is the main difference. It will be a different theory topics. Maybe we'll have some discussion, and I will post some of the theory contents about like object references, etc. And I will put that in my forum so that you can able to see that. Okay, so any doubt in this? Any doubt in this dynamic dispatch method and method to like overriding, the concept of overriding, and how to prevent the concept of overriding like that? Any doubt in that? Any doubt?